करता हूँ। होप यू आर ऑल फाइन डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे आई विल शो यू वन प्रेजेंटेशन दैट इज़ अबाउट इंटरनेट, हाउ इंटरनेट विल वर्क। एंड एक्चुअली दिस इज फॉर स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स एंड दोज हु आर वॉन्ट टू नो समथिंग अबाउट इंटरनेट, हाउ इट विल वर्क एंड टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरनेट एंड ऑल। सो दिस इज माई ओल्ड प्रेजेंटेशन, बट इट्स a nice kind of presentation, and I just want to at least show to the students, those who are interested. So let me just introduce my presentation, which is here. This is my first slide. Let me just show you how it will work and all everything in step wise. Just you can go through it. Okay, just let me run this one. It's here, right? Okay, now first of all, most of you know that how important internet, and everyone is using mobiles and all, and without internet it's very difficult. Now just you should have some basic knowledge what type of connections you can use to get to the internet. So it's here now, guys. So be stick with me and just at least watch carefully so that you know that. Let me just get this. The very first one is a dial-up connection, and the second one is DSL, digital service subscriber, and third one is cable internet access. You can get through via cable. And the fourth one is 3G, and the last one is Wi-Fi. That's what we are all using. Let me just here click on the number to get the more information. I'll just click on it and you see what will happen. If I click on this, see, I will get the, this is about dial-up. What does the dial-up will do? And that is very very old technique, and most of them I remember how I used to connect to the internet by using dial-up. So now dial-up connection, you need to use a telephone line. You should have a telephone at your home, then only you can get internet connection. It requires a kind of device which is called modulator, and in short we call it as a modem. That will be set up in between the your PC and your computer or laptop, so that you can access the internet. Actually a modem, it will provide an interface between your PC and telephone. And here is the picture. Let me just you can have a clear clarification what does it do. So modem in between these two telephone lines, see how you are connecting a modem with that, and the information will be transferred in the form of binary, that is nothing but a zeros and one. And now let me go back to the again the main menu. This is the second one. What is the second one? Is DSL. The acronym start for digital subscriber line. So it is a form of broadband connection. It provide a connection over the telephone line. I remember most of the big companies, MNCs, they use a separate subscriber line so that they will have a faster and a proper and reliable connectivity. So now let's here is the diagram how it will work. So now you need to have a DSL connection. You can subscribe and then you can get the internet connection. Mostly most of the companies, what they will do, they will use this kind of connection. They pay the big amount to the service provider and get this kind of info internet by using a router, and they connect lot of devices like that. And now a third one is 3G. Most of them know what is 3G and all it, especially when the mobiles are invented. In that case they use this technology. Everyone see what will happen in that see cable internet access. You will have see through cables you get the connection. Most of the homes also people used to subscribe this line. That will be a little bit cheaper, while so the subscriber will provide a proper line through a cable, and you get a TV, whatever it may be, like cake. You can watch a TV as well as you can use mobile and all like that. Now Fourth one is 3G guys. See, 3G, it's a short form of third generation, is a set of standard used in mobile devices and communication services. We subscribe the 3G connectivity with the ISP provider. In order to get an internet connection, you have to subscribe to any service provider. They will provide you the internet connection and all. Now see, here is the way how you get the information. See, you might have seen a lot of towers on the roads and all. So with the help of radiation, you may get the access through. See, here is the new connection of cable and all like that. You can get it. So now in between, see, there are gateways are there, and from that you get the internet connection, and this is how it will work. And see, the I hear the phone, how they will access the information through the radiation actually. And you can see that how it you get on a PC also, you see that this kind of simulation when you connect to the internet. And the last one is guys, the Wi-Fi, which is very popular and everyone is using. This is Wi-Fi is a mainstream innovation that permits the electronic gadgets, an example of computers and cell phones, and a lot of school students and college students, everyone now all depends on a Wi-Fi. Even if you go to have a cup of tea or coffee, you look for a Wi-Fi, free Wi-Fi, or if they are providing and all like that, so that you can utilize your time by watching something or browsing something. Now here is the figure. Now here is see the how the devices are connected with the Wi-Fi. The devices connect to the hospital or colleges, whatever it may be, it will be so easy. Nowadays you can see that a handy kind of sub small USD type of small modem, that also you can carry, and you can just plug in and just make use of it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll just go back and wrap it my presentation. Hope you are all like it. So this is I just include in my presentation just to know how internet work and all. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice and wonderful time. Thank you.